FSU Skydiving Club. Loftier in that it deals in high places and exclusive in the sense that not everyone has the desire to join. At present, there are... The organization goes by the title of the USU Skydiving Club and is eligible to use certain campus facilities. It receives no funds from the university and has not been given any financial assistance for this year. According to club spokesman... Persons engaged in free falling must be certified and rated by the Federal Aviation Agency. The ratings start at the bottom with an A license and progress upwards to a D license, the highest rating available. In order to receive an A license, a person must have a minimum of 25 free falls and prove to be of sufficient ability in this art. In order to gain a D license, 205 free falls are needed with delays up to 60 seconds and the ability to land with certain distances of specified targets. Mr. Fonsbeck, the possessor of a C rating, is certified to teach students. Peace. If a person should decide to purchase his own equipment, estimated at approximately $90 for novices, the price per jump is $375.
sharp, clean sand. Using a piece of wood with a straight edge, make your furrows 1/2 inch deep. Water thoroughly and put aside to drain. Sow the seeds thinly in rows and cover lightly with sand or moss. Sprinkle with water and cover with a sheet of plastic film. Put it into a warm 70-degree temperature, but not in the sun. When the seedlings appear, remove the plastic film and place the seedlings in a warm, sunny window where they'll get at least 6 hours of sunlight daily. After the seedlings develop their first true leaves, they're ready for transplanting. You can transplant them into pots made of peat that you buy at your garden supply store. Put the pots into an aluminum pan with holes. Transplanted plants will grow in the home windows. Light is a good way to harden them. If you'd like a vegetable guide, send 15 cents to Extension TV, Utah State University, Logan, Utah, 84321.